Good Day to Die Hard short movie review. John McClane has not seen his son for 3 years, so he goes to Russia where he's been arrested, and he kind of gets in the middle of a situation. Wrong place, wrong time, but not really a Die Hard movie. It has some of the aspects, but they're clearly shoehorned in. It's really quite hard to believe that this was actually written as a Die Hard movie, when in fact it was the only one that was always written as a Die Hard movie. And essentially, it's a so-so big dumb action movie with all that entails. The stupid twists, the convoluted plot, and some things that you might not expect, such as really impeccably poor continuity to the point where it ruins the illusion and takes you out of the movie. And this happens a lot during the movie, and a lot of the action scenes are filmed and edited so clumsily that you can't tell where people are in relation to each other, including in the car chase, which is potentially one of the best action scenes in the movie. And yeah, car chase where you aren't sure how close the pursuer is to the, yeah, that kind of speaks for itself as just how bad that is. And on the positive side, the several big set pieces are nicely spaced out and don't tend to go on for too long, even if they are quite generic and tedious. And they do tend to be stunts over CGI, which is very nice. This is an R-rated film, but it's not a hard R, or just barely hard R at least, with very little blood or violence and one brief bit of gore. And it does kind of feel like the R rating was kind of a last minute decision, like it was cut up to an R. You can kind of tell that it's the same director as Max Payne. It's just not all that effective, and for as well choreographed as the action can be, and utterly unsurvivable for good guys and bad guys alike, it's, yeah, as I've already mentioned, just so badly shot and edited too much of the time. The father-son relationship is not done very well, and even if it's something you don't really care about, believe me, you're gonna end up caring about it, because it's bothersome. The two have no chemistry, in spite of both of them giving both good performances, and Bruce Willis comes off as just kind of a whiny old guy. It's just complaining about how he should have been a better father, and it's just, it doesn't ring true, it doesn't feel real, and Bruce Willis really isn't playing John McClane in this movie. He has a few of the same traits, but there's almost nothing of the edge that made the first three Die Hard movies such action classics. If you like this review and want a more detailed one, check below, it's there as a video response. If not, it'll be in the description box. Please rate and comment, and hey, if you like this video, that subscribe button's just waiting for you to click it.